Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name's Matt, and today I want to take you through Cullen Kelly's contour plugin for DaVinci Resolve. This is a look development plugin that I've been using for over a year now. I purchased it with my own money, and I have no affiliation with Cullen Kelly color whatsoever. These are just my own personal thoughts and opinions on the plugin itself. The purpose of this video is basically to take you through the plugin if you've been looking at it, wondering if you want to purchase the plugin, or just wanting to know a little bit more about it. This is basically how I use the plugin. It's a little bit of a walkthrough slash review of it after a year of using it. I really like this plugin. I think there are so many great aspects to it, but I also know that it's not going to be suited to everyone. So in today's video, I want to take you through that and basically show you my process, and you can decide whether it's worth it for you or not. So without any further ado, let's jump to the grading suite and let me show you what this plugin's all about. Okay, now we're in Resolve, and very quickly before we start, I guess I should explain what Contour is. It's a plugin designed by Cullen Kelly and his team. Cullen Kelly being a well-known colorist. You can find him here on YouTube, and he does a lot of great educational resources for Resolve, but this is a look development plugin for DaVinci Resolve. And what that means and what he's kind of marketed it as is it's a tool to help you build looks that you can then deploy. You can either use them in Resolve for your just for your grading, or you could export these looks out. You could send a cinematographer a LUT to use on set, a show LUT is what they call it, to be able to then basically film with this look. So pricing, I had to go back to the website for this, but it's about $500 at the moment as a one-off purchase. For some reason, it's also $450 for the year, but I definitely recommend spending the extra $50 on the one-time purchase. And then you've also got $135 for a quarter if you just need it for a quarter. So what I want to do first is show you how I use the plugin in DaVinci Resolve. So what I've got right now is just a very short timeline of a few clips that I've shot with the Blazar Remus lenses. I do need to get some better test footage. This is just the stuff that I can show you that I've sort of shot in my spare time, but it's definitely a goal of mine to get some more footage to use for this channel. I've got a bit of a test sequence down here, and I've set it up in the way that I would usually grade these kind of sequences. So what that entails is basically I've selected all these clips, I've added them into a group. You can click add into new group. Mine's already just called contour. And then from there, you go into the group pre-clip, and I've added a CST, a color space transform. I've literally just finished editing the previous video and I said camera space transform. Anyway, color space transform over here. I'm going from S log 3 over to DaVinci wide gamut. And then my group post clip, I've got another CST, which is my CST out. And this is basically going from DaVinci wide gamut to Rec 709 gamma 2.4. So anything on the clip level, anything on the group post clip before this node is working in DaVinci wide gamut. And so what I'll generally do is on the post clip up here is I'm going to add a node before by hitting Shift S. I'm going to search for contour. And here we go, we've got 2.1.9, which is the latest version as of October 2025. And I'm gonna drag this on top of this node. And now I've got contour added, right? So I'm not gonna go through every single slider and feature in this plugin, but I'll just highlight a few of the key things in here for you to look out for. Cullen already does a great job of explaining this in the educational materials. There's also a great manual for contour as well, which will go through every single feature and tell you what it does. But I just wanna show you some of the things that I really like about this plugin. So starting with the working space, you can choose if you wanna work in DaVinci Intermediate, Aces CCT, or RE Log C3. For the most part, I'm always in DaVinci Intermediate, which is exactly what I just did before with those color space transforms. You also have the option to import profiles. So I believe Contour comes with a set of profiles. This is not all of them. There's just a few there that Cullen has supplied with the plugin. And then you've also got the option to export a profile. So if you do some adjustments in here and you really like what you've done, you can then export that profile out to send to someone or to utilize in your later projects as well. And then finally, you could export a LUT out of here directly from Contour if you wanted to. That's a 65-point LUT. And that could, again, be utilized by someone else, or it could be utilized by yourself in the future. So starting at the beginning, we've got the curve. We've got our contrast curves. Effectively, this is our contrast in the image. So I'm just basically adjusting my contrast there, but there's a lot more to it, which I'll go through in a second. We've got our split, which is effectively split toning the image and adding different colors into our highlights and into our shadows. And we've got a whole bunch of control in here. Our saturation allows us to sort of add saturation to certain parts of the image. So it could be our lows, it could be our mids, it could be our highs. And we could also just basically choose where in the image this saturation lives. We've then got split saturation, which is effectively adding saturation into our lower end while taking it away from our higher end. So if I sort of increase it here, this is probably not the best clip for it. If I go over to this clip, this is really gonna demonstrate it. As I increase it, you can tell the sky almost looks like it's getting hotter. It looks like it's increasing in luminance. It's not, we're just taking away the saturation, but we're still keeping the saturation. We're actually adding saturation to the lower parts of the image. We've got density, which if I look at another image here and I sort of increase density, this is what I came to know as cinematic saturation, which is effectively rather than just adding color into the image, we're actually sort of reducing the luminance of certain color channels. And that's then getting us this more filmic saturation. It feels like we're adding weight to the image through the density slider. And we have the option to kind of bias it between different colors. We can also choose the amount of focus. So if we want to have it sort of affect a bit less of the image, because density can get pretty intense pretty quickly, we can adjust where that focus goes as well. And lastly, with our hues, very self-explanatory, but I can basically just choose where these colors live in the image. If I want to add some more blue into the sky, I can literally just move this slider back. I've just moved the reds a little bit as well. And then there's, again, we can change all the colors there if we'd like to. So some of the more unique things in this plugin, which I want to highlight, is things like the visual overlays, which I actually really have come to love. I feel like if you are someone who's working in your custom curves over here and you're drawing a curve, there's like a very visual aspect to what you're doing, which allows you to see the kind of contrast that you're adding to the image, right? Whereas with this plugin, you actually have a show contrast curve. And as I adjust it, I'm able to see that contrast curve move. If I adjust things like the black point, I can see how far up that black point's going. I can also adjust things like the toe length. So if I want to move that more towards our middle pivot point, I can do that as well. And then adjust things like the strength. So we're sort of adding a little bit more contrast by pushing that curve a little bit lower in that bottom section. And then I've also got things like preserve color, which allow me to either have the color in the image stay the same when I add contrast, or I can go ahead and like reduce that down. And so basically as I'm adding contrast, I'm also increasing saturation. So that's just one example with the contrast curve, but with the split curve, exactly the same thing, probably even more powerful. If I turn this on and basically increase the split, you can see that curve is basically expanding to show me where the split is happening. And then I could do things, for example, like adjust the shadow hue, which is really helpful to have these sort of two different color blocks in the corner here to show me where it's going. If I want this to be more yellow, I'm gonna go over to more yellow. This is a very extreme split, obviously, right? I don't think this is the right kind of split, but you know, just to show it off, you also then have the option to kind of have a neutral segment width in this particular module, which I really like. And this is kind of marketed towards when you have a subject in there with skin tones. If you sort of have this turned off, it's absolutely going to start affecting those skin tones wherever they live in the image. Whereas neutral segment can kind of help you to control that split in that middle section, most likely where your skin tones are exposed, to then make sure it's not affecting it as heavily. And again, adding a lot of split into someone's skin tones, which is going to become very obvious very quickly. You also have things like saturation masks or luminance masks, depending on the module. So for example, with our split curve, if I turn on highlight mode, I can actually choose what part of the image this lives in terms of saturation, right? This image is probably not the best one, but if I go here, for example, I can then invert that saturation mask and just have it affect these more saturated parts of the image. And then if I undo highlight mode, and I'll turn off this curve, it's just affecting that part of the image. But really importantly, and what I wanna really emphasize in this demo, is since getting this plugin and since using it and sort of learning how to use it, I've really seen it as a look development plugin, which is what Cullen really sort of markets this thing as and how he likes to use it, right? Which is kind of how he teaches everyone to use it. But adding it at a group post clip level, adding it to a series of clips, then makes you start to think differently about how you're setting up a look, right? Before I had this plugin, I would kind of grade on a clip level. So I'd have like, you know, a clip and I'd have a bunch of nodes on the clip. My node tree would look a little bit bigger than that, but you know, I'd basically adjust certain things in this particular node tree. And then, you know, I might add the look at the end. And then I might ripple that sort of node to every single clip, right? To create the look of the overall image. Or, you know, some people like might put a LUT on the timeline, for example, or a group post clip. this is really making you start to think about, okay, I'm making adjustments, right? I'm thinking about my like saturation mask, for example, that looks a bit terrifying, but thinking about my saturation mask, it's not just for this shot, it's for all the shots, right? So anytime there is like a lot of saturation in an image, we're adding split to it now. And so what's really helpful about that is kind of thinking about your grading in a different way. I'm grading for the overall sequence, I'm not grading for one clip. And so if I basically go to these clips now, and what I might do is I might do something really obvious, right? I might lift the black point because it's something on YouTube, I'm really conscious. I want people to be able to see it, right? If I lift the black point pretty significantly and I go to all my clips, now they kind of match in that way, right? And I think that's what's really important to think about. We could still absolutely do grading on a shot by shot level because you might find shots don't match. You know, for example, actually, I think I've already done it here, but this shot is shot at a different time, believe it or not, than this shot, which means that this shot had totally different colors. So basically just adding a balance adjustment on this shot brought it more in line. Like there could still be some more work done there to match it a little bit better. As you can tell, like all the levels gone at the back here with the bookshelf compared to this shot. But you know, what's holding it together is the group post clip, and it's holding it together because the look has been applied to all of those different clips. And that's what I really like about contour is basically everything is here, right? Every adjustment you want to make on an image is kind of just in this one plugin. So I guess just touching on a couple of things I love about this plugin. The first thing is I love that it's very opinionated. It has a point of view, and I really do appreciate this about plugins. I think the worst kind of plugins for me are ones that just throw everything in the kitchen sink at you and go, yeah, you've got all the control in the world, but you know, really, we have no idea what you're supposed to do with this either. We just know it achieves a certain result. So good luck, go enjoy yourself. And you know, hopefully you get some good results. And those plugins might be really powerful in certain ways, but they're not fun to use. And they're not enjoyable in the sense that you always want to use them because you actually have a good time using them and you always achieve great results. You might spend a lot of time in there adjusting sliders and going like, how's this going to work? And you know, what's this setting here? And how do I adjust it to make it look like this? And all of a sudden it's like, okay, I've taken so much time. I might do it once or twice, but I don't want to do it every single grade. And I think contour for me, like just because it is a very opinionated plugin about how it goes about the process of this, right? Adjusting a contrast, adjusting a split, saturation, density. Funnily enough, this is not the order that contour actually processes it in the background, but it's the order that it shows it to you because this feels, I guess, like the most natural way to grade, right? You sort of start with your contrast, which again, human eyes, we're more sensitive to our contrast and our luminance than we are to colors themselves. And that's why our split is after that. That's why our saturation is after it, you know, because then again, then we're adjusting the colors. We get our contrast right first, then we adjust the colors. And so I really like that about contour. I really like how there's an opinion behind it. If you listen to Cullen talk about it and all his educational material, it's very much like this is a plugin I designed for myself and I'm just giving it to you guys because this is how I'd like to work and how I'd like to use it. I think the plugin's changed slightly since coming out because people have all given him feedback and he's kind of integrated a little bit of that. But yeah, I really like the fact that this plugin has, it's really trying to encourage you to grade a certain way. For some people, they might like that. Other people might go, I'm happy with the way I'm doing it right now. What I also like about contour is it's really lightweight. You know, you could add multiple instances of contour if you really wanted to, and you know, your process is not going to slow down. This is like a 4K timeline. You know, I'm not really doing much on contour at the moment, but like, you know, I might just go ahead and increase my split strength. I'm going to increase my contrast. You know, I've got multiple instances, still kind of playing back in real time without caching. So the great thing is if you wanted to, you could add multiple instances of contour. You could use it on a clip level and a group post clip level if you really wanted to. The great thing is I never feel like contour itself is slowing me down in the grading process, which again, massive plus for me. As soon as you get a plugin that's like a big film emulation plugin and you have to like turn on caching and then every little adjustment takes forever to render again, that can get really time consuming. And again, isn't always the best feeling when you're trying to grade quickly. So maybe what are some of the things to consider about contour? I would say the biggest one and probably where you'll get the most feedback around contour is everything you are doing here can be done in Resolve in some way. And that's probably true of a lot of plugins for DaVinci Resolve. It's definitely not unique that, you know, you don't have to have a plugin that does something extra super special for you. But I would say there is a lot in here that, again, even especially with split these days, DaVinci Resolve 20 has just integrated a new split module, a new split OFX plugin. So if you want to do split, you used to have to do it from this like custom curve and now you can just put an OFX plugin on there and do it from there. What I would say though is the speed that you get from working in the one plugin is going to be worth it to some people and not worth it to others. And it's funny because, like, for me, the one thing that I always come back to, and one of my favorite Resolve courses I ever watched, was watching the colorist of Suits on Low Post does a sort of series of videos where he talks about his color grading process. And it's so funny because you go on YouTube and everyone's got these massive node trees and they're all taking their time to like go through on like a frame level, right? Just looking at one frame and being like, okay, we're going to do all this stuff and do all these power windows. And then you've got the guy from Suits who's just like, yep, I've got 700 shots to grade today. I've got footage from an Arri Alexa that's already been like converted to Rec 709. And I'm just going to make sure the exposure levels match. I'm going to make sure I add a power window. And I was like, wow, this is like a real colorist, you know, like this is a real working colorist in the sense that he's just got to get through 700 shots on a TV show day to day. And he's got no time to sit around and like play with power windows or like maybe try some blooming effects here. And, you know, like these really complex keys of colors. He's just like, go, go, go. And I think, you know, again, when you are working on a project, sometimes you might be in the fortunate position. You might be a top-end colorist who has the time to sit down and go through and really talk about a look and how it's going to look and feel and you know, what sort of processes you're going to use as a way to do that. But for a lot of people, myself included, I need to work quickly. I don't have that ability to sort of sit around for weeks going, how do I want this to look and feel and what could I integrate as a bunch of tools? It's always going to be, what do I have access to right now? And I think that's where I really love Contour. I feel like Contour is just something that I can drop in and I know I can start playing around with sliders and go, okay, things like a split. You know, sometimes I wouldn't have even thought of doing a split. But now that I have access to it here on Contour, it's just like nice and easy for me to start and just basically see what a split might look like. If it's the right move, if it's not, that's okay. But at least I've tried it and I've tried it really quickly. And so I think the benefit there is speed. But for some people who are looking at it going, that's a really steep asking price, they might also go, I can already do that already in Resolve. I don't need this plugin. But that's a little look into Cullen Kelly's Contour plugin in DaVinci Resolve, a look development plugin, which I think is well worth it, but I understand it's gonna depend on who you are and how your process works. And that's gonna do it for this video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and you can also find the plugin link in the description there as well. Like the video if you're enjoying the content and make sure to subscribe if you wanna see more, and I'll see you all in the next one.